14 Palestinians killed and dozens more injured after Israeli airstrikes hit a refugee camp located in the central part of Gaza Strip. Other airstrikes were reported in Deir al-Bala in central Gaza and Rafah in the far south. The attack comes after Hamas said an Israeli proposal on a ceasefire in their war in Gaza did not meet the demands of Palestinian militant factions, but it would study the offer nonetheless and deliver its response to mediators.
Local government units in the National Capital Region adjust working hours to help ease traffic congestion. That's after the Metro Manila Council passed a resolution shifting work hours in government offices from the traditional 8 a.m. to 5 p.m. to 7 a.m. until 4 in the afternoon. This modified schedule will allow government workers in Metro Manila to go home earlier, easing road conditions during peak hours late in the afternoon to evening.
Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. flies to Washington for a summit with U.S. President Joe Biden and Japanese Prime Minister Fumio Kishida. He left this afternoon for the U.S., where Marcos says he will push for stronger ties with Washington and Tokyo. The president is due to meet with U.S. business leaders while in Washington to once more invite them to invest in the country. He also reiterated that the summit will mainly discuss economic matters, but would also discuss maintaining peace in the Indo-Pacific region.
Of course, security and defense is going to be part of that discussion. But nonetheless, I think I can assure everyone that that is not the main intent of this trilateral agreement. The main intent of this trilateral agreement is for us to be able to continue to flourish, to be able to help one another, and of course, to keep the peace in the South China Sea and the freedom of navigation in the South China Sea.
A White House advisor, meanwhile, told journalists during a briefing that several initiatives in key areas are expected to be announced in the summit, including investments for the Philippines.
Those include energy security, which of course is a very important focus for this government. They include digital connectivity to make sure that the people of the Philippines have access to reliable, trusted networks, and a number of other areas, which if we can more effectively hone our trilateral cooperation, will make the Philippines' economy stronger and will affect the everyday lives of the Philippines people.
The Philippines sees more foreign direct investments in January. Our numbers that matter today, $970 million. The central bank says this was the FDI net inflows at the start of the year, higher by 90% from the over $470 million last year. It is also an improvement from the more than $820 million in December. The BSP points to higher debt instrument investments from foreign nationals, which climbed to $820 million. Foreign investments in equity capital, meanwhile, declined to $11 million from the previous $93 million. Monetary authorities say most of the equity capital placements were from Japan and the U.S. The investments were channeled mostly to the manufacturing, real estate, and construction sectors.